Oh, gee. Oh, God. Oh.
Hi, folks. Larry here, Mobile Tech, with CanDamTrailers.com. I know you haven't heard from me for a little bit, but you have seen some older videos that I found that hadn't been edited, and I popped them up there from the main line. As many of you may know, last month I got my sinuses roto-rooted. I had an operation on my sinuses, 2 days after which the smoke started. So it made recovery very difficult. Today, finally, we have a semi-clear day here where I live, but it's still smoky. So, but it's okay enough for me to be outside. At any rate, I've been wanting to show you the inside of the Deville. This is the 59 Deville that I picked up not too long ago from Jim. It needs to be emptied out. It's full of junk. It's full of a lot of its own parts, and it's kind of in disarray. And so I moved it over here to the campsite. Now, this is the spot where when my friends visit me with RVs, I let them back in here. It doesn't matter the size because, you know, I got a huge back area here. I have put the biggest motorhome you can put in here. the biggest motorhome that there is. When my friend Tom came to visit with Cheryl, we just did his ashes down in Paris in free fall. So I'll put a tag up here for that video if you'd like to see that. He died at the age of 74 from cancer, and we said our last farewell to him last weekend. At any rate, we're going to open this trailer up, we're going to empty it out, and we're going to see what's in it. Find out how many parts it came with and how many it didn't. The first thing I want to show you people before we open the door is something a lot of people ask me about. They go, what the heck is that? What is this thing? This little thing here, what happens is when you have a lever handle on your door, the lever is like this normally, and if you push down on it, it opens the door and it wants to spring back up. Well, you put that lever behind here. And this is what holds the door open. It's got a little bump stop here. And you see these on a lot of the 50s trailers. So that's what it's for. This doesn't have a lever handle. As you can see over here, somebody put a doorknob on it. That's going to change. We'll rebuild this door and make it back to original. Somebody really did a heavy-duty job of trying to make sure that people can't break in, when actually all they have to do is bust a window and they can go right in. So why do all that? Yeah, it's pretty beefy what happened here. So let's go ahead and open the door. And yeah, Sabrina wants in, but there's no room for her yet. She's going over there and growling at the new neighbors. All right, so it did come with this nice step. Thank you, Jim. So I'm going to take the GoPro in there and we'll take a look around before we start removing things. GoPro has a little wider angle lens and so it can see things easier. But as we come in, we notice right away that the dinette seats are out of place. That's okay. We can build new if we need to, but it looks like some of the stuff is here. Like here's one. Kind of where it goes. And I don't know what that is over there, but that looks like one too. All right, so they're here. No paneling on this wall, that's okay. No paneling in front, that's okay. And the key sheet is missing, that's okay too. You did a lot of work on the cabinet so that I won't have to do. Pretty nice. Just a little bit of touch up in the corner is a new GIMP. And that'll work out nicely. And of course I'll replace all these panels in the ceiling. I'll just replace the entire wrap probably. This cabinet, he's done a lot of work too, and it's already pretty nice. A little bit of touch up, new GIMP. We'll replace all the ceiling framing. In other words, the entire wrap. And of course, this trailer is going to get all new metal too. Here's some of the old J-rail right here. We're going to get all this out. There's the old refrigerator, or actually ice box, and the table. The stove is here. And I believe the grates are, yeah, they're right over here. So it's complete. Not sure where these this cabinet door is that goes here. That's, I'm not seeing it anywhere in here, so I may have to build a new cabinet door, but that's okay. I can do that. No problem. So I will build a new cabinet door for that. One thing I always liked about the Devilles, they got this little cabinet here, which he's already refinished, and it looks great. Some people take these shelves out, take the bottom one out, and put slots in the top for wine bottles. And, yeah, I may do that. So, I want to just start emptying it out so I can make some room in here and see more of what we have and what we are going to need. Get this J-rail out of here right now. Out of my way. Okay, I'll get this icebox out. Here's the old license plate. We'll leave that in here. I'm going to get this icebox out of here. Don't need that in my way. Okay, now I'm going to show you something. Here's a box of stuff that came with it. Sometimes, many times in these old trailers, they don't clean them out. And you'll find all kinds of little treasures in there. Here's some photos of the cushions. And, oh, what's this? Probably a first aid kit, yeah. Old first aid kit. It's empty. But yeah, lots of little things in here. Here's some Naga hide or vinyl, whatever. Some blankets. A thing to put in the refrigerator, I guess, or something. Yeah, there, you never know what you're going to find in these old things. One time, a friend of mine found $1,500 in cash in an old trailer that he bought. So, you know, pays to look. All right, I'm gonna keep getting this stuff out of here. Time being, it'd be a good place to set things. And I'm even going to keep the table in here. I might set that up for the time being, just to be able to set things on. We have trim for the wind. No, this must be for the icebox. I'll put that in here. Trim for the table. I'll keep that. That out here. Damage it. Trim for the countertop, which matches. That will end up going right there. You can see. See, it fits. We'll hang on to that. Trim for the sink. Goes right there. The battery box, which is full of junk. See, that's why I put that table up there. I can start getting things out. Oh! Boy, you never know. Here's a multi-tool, hardly ever used. In the box. It's a multi-tool. Thanks, Jim. You should have hung on to that. I know you can use that at your old place or your new place. Probably replace this, but don't really need to. It's just, you know, but that's for the license plate holder. I don't even look at those. Just want to get them out of my way. Turtle wax is trash, basically. I should bring a trash can over here.
one of these things. It's worthless. A mat. Oh, I can use that for camping. Small, lightweight, car camping. The sink. I'll just go ahead and put that where it goes for right now. It's right here. Oh, it doesn't fit in that hole. I mean, it doesn't fit down in the hole. You're not seeing anything because I put this in the way. See, that screws up from underneath. That's why it doesn't fit in that hole. It screws up from underneath. That's the way those are put in. So, getting stuff towards the door here. So I'll put the sink. The sink's in really good shape. So I'll put that out of the way. Getting harder and harder to find that stuff. Remove, how about that? Curtain rods. There's a brow. Oh, it's been polished one. Nice. Curtain rod. Stick for something. More of those in there. Here's the handle for the vent. Here are the tracks for the table. All right. So, I'm gonna go get the shop vac and start sucking up some of this mouse crap. It's actually rat trap crap. It's too big for mouse crap. And the last thing we'll get out is these seats and put those in storage. So, there's the original fluorine marmoleum. Standard type stuff that they used. Easy to get up using that multi-tool with the chisel. Not the chisel, but the putty knife type blade on it. Has no teeth. Also, if you heat that stuff, it comes up much easier. You're using a heat gun. And yeah, from what I can see, I will be building a door for that. No problem. All right. Okay. So stuff I want to keep for the trailer will go in here. Just like the ice box. It's gonna go away in there. Setting up this thing. Jeez, some things are really tough to deal with. Okay, I think it's time for the vacuum, so I'll take the shop stuff to the shop and get the vacuum while I'm in there. All right, I got things out of my way, so I'm going in. Surprise that I wasn't expecting. It's a gaucho bed. I didn't expect that at all. My other one was, that was a 58. It was a full-time bed. This is a gaucho. You can see it's got the boxes that it slides on. And there's some really bad rat poop that's been liquefied and solidified in the corners and stuff. I gotta get in here with some liquid cleaner and stuff and get those. Then also, I'm not gonna open that door down there, but back there, you talk about rat crap. And you can see they've kinda eaten this all up, but it's the original. This looks like it's the original mattress because it fits, it folds up. That's what these gauchos do. They fold up just like that. Shasta's got the same kind. So, I have a template. I can take this to a upholsterer and say, build me a new one. Actually, I may have some new ones that'll fit. I'm not sure. Got to look at the ones I have in there for another trailer that I'm not going to use them in. But anyway, yeah, that's the surprise. Now, as you can see here, somebody added a panel in the back. There, see? It's screwed in with a, you know, they got screws all through it. Yeah, they use drywall screws. But, you know, it's over the gimp. And, yeah, that's a phony panel that was put over the rotten stuff. That's all going to come out. The entire wrap will come out. Got a pile of stuff here. So, still working on cleaning. That's the main thing today is just get it clean. Got the seats somewhat in their places. And just for kicks, I may temporarily screw them all back together. Just so I'll have a place to put the seats and store them. And at the same time, I can put up the table. So I can actually sit in here if I want. Because we're not going to start working on this one yet. I'm just cleaning it out. I got to finish the Jewel, and I got to finish the 48 mainline, and I got to finish the 59 Shasta, and I got to finish the Campster before I can start this. But this is our next class project. But yeah, there's the big surprise, gaucho bed. All right, this next job is going to require gloves and a breather because yeah, this is nasty. I've already looked in there. It's underneath the gaucho. There is a lot of rat poop there. So I'm going to don my mask and my gloves. I'm going to open up the side door and attack it from there first. I won't be able to get it at all from the side door, but it's a good place to start because it's outside. To get in there, I'll probably have to remove the mattress, and I'm not into that today. So I'm going to get as much as I can here, but you'll see what I'm talking about. Ooh. Bad news.
All right, here we go. I'll take the GoPro.
Oh, gee. Oh my God. Oh.
Okay. Ugh. Well, I need a stick to hold this up. Am I running? Yeah. There you go.
Yeah.
I don't know what that is. So anyway, yeah. Get some of the big stuff out first. Oh, these are jack stands. That's good. All right. Yeah. I took that right over to the burn barrel. Here's the next layer. Oh God. That's going to the burn barrel too. Straight to the burn barrel. I got a lot of vacuuming to do out here. Some spillage. There's one more.
That's all the stuff that's solidified that's got to be scraped out. That won't vacuum up. I got back to about 2 feet from the other side. I'm going to have to go in from the inside for that. I'll do that another time. Yuck.
Whew. I can breathe again. I have never seen that much rat crap in any one trailer in my entire life. That's the most I've ever seen. And it's caked up. Some of it's been liquefied, maybe from them peeing on it or whatever, and then solidified. So there's these big, huge areas I'm going to have to scrape up. Oh, God, that's not going to be fun. So I'm going to have to use, like, a bleach solution to do it with, and then be sucking it up with this thing while I'm doing it. It's not going to be fun at all. We'll leave that for another time. I'm pretty much done for the day. But yeah, I just want to let you guys know what's going on. And I wanted to share cleaning out the 59 Deville with you, because it's usually the first thing you have to do when you get a trailer home. You got to clean it out. And sometimes you find little surprises in it. Like I say, one guy found $1,500 in cash in an envelope. I found a multi-tool and a few other tidbits that will be neat to have, stuff that costs money that I won't have to, you know, like I just found those screw jacks for leveling the trailer with, those cost money, so those go nicely with this stand and the step, and yeah, we're off to a good start with 59 Deville. So, like I say, now I've got more metal videos coming for the main line. If you've been waiting for the grand finale on that, it's coming. I just haven't had time to do any editing, and I've got to get that one edited. Actually, that's a couple of them. We've got the top on. It's all fastened down and nailed in. We just got to get the edge trim on now, and then we can get it shot with two coats of clear coat, UV resistant clear coat, and then the glass goes in. So we're coming to the end here on that one, and I'll share that one with you later. So with that, this is Mobile Tech from not so smoky Northern Nevada. Remember, folks, I make mistakes so you don't have to. We'll see you next time. Have a good one. Take care of each other. Old Sputnik pattern, just like my 58 had. So now we get an idea of what it looks like, what it will look like. That'll be the new handle for it eventually.